also committed to.
I wanted to follow up on the forum last night. You were asked about your email, sir.
Yes, uh-huh.
And you said that you did not make an error in judgment because you did nothing wrong.
Right.
Yet last fall, you said that you should have used two email servers, one for work, one for business.
Right.
That to me sounded like an admission of an error in judgment. Why would that not be the case?
Well, you know, look, I just think that it was a mistake not to have used two, because it's caused all of this, you know, all of this uproar and commotion. The fact is, I sent all my work-based emails to state.gov addresses, so they were in the system, and so there was no, you know, there was no break in what would have happened if I'd been doing it from a separate email account. And so at the end of the day, I think it's kind of a wash. But it was a mistake, because who wants to put people through all of this? I don't want to go through it. I don't want to put, you know, a lot of my friends through it. So yeah. It was a mistake.
So it was a mistake because of the reaction.
Yes,
to it.
Not absolutely.
Not because
yeah. It
would have made sense to use a work email for
it. It made sense.
Purposes.
Look, I know that this remains a subject of some interest. Obviously, you're asking me. They asked me last night. The facts have not changed. I made a decision, which at the time I thought was a convenient decision. It was permitted. I did it. Nobody ever said anything contrary to me. Then, when I said, let my emails become public, that was something nobody else has ever done at all in the government. Maybe you can get them in 50 years, but I'm doing it in real time. Look, I regret that this has caused so much of a diversion, which I think is unfounded, but I will continue to answer the questions that I'm asked about it.
I'll just ask one other thing about this. Some have suggested that this is a certain stubbornness on your part, an inability to admit a mistake. What do you say?
Well, I said I was wrong about the Iraq War, and that is something I'm still asked about. I'm sorry that I used one instead of two email accounts, but I don't think that goes to the judgment and experience of the person running for to be president. If that were, everybody I know of would be disqualified. So I just can't answer any other way other than to say I've been more transparent, more forthcoming than anybody who's ever been in public office up until this time. And there's nothing more I can do about it. So.
Would there be a policy in the Clinton administration to handle this? Would it be a learning experience for the administration?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. The rules that were in place when I was there, just as my predecessors. Mm-hmm. Now, let's not forget, my two predecessors also used the same approach. They were asked to turn over their work-related emails,
yes.
And they said, oh, my gosh, that's so long ago, we don't have any of that. So that was the process in place at the time. I inherited that process, and because of all this, these very difficult experiences for people being subjected to all these questions and everything, of course, I would be highly encouraging that the rules be absolutely clear, because I don't want anybody else to ever have to go through this.
Got a question on the Affordable Health Care Act.
Mm-hmm.
We've got two camps.